Thank you all. I just listened to the Speaker of the House. Speaker Pelosi happens to be the Speaker of this House, but she does not speak for America when it comes to this issue. She cannot decide unilaterally what happens here. They have been investigating this president before he even got elected. They have voted three times on impeachment on this floor. Twice they voted before one word of the Mueller report came back. Our job here is a serious job. Our job is to focus on the American public. Our job is to make tomorrow better than today. Our job is to legislate, not to continue to investigate something in the back when you cannot find any reason to impeach this president. This election is over. I realize 2016 did not turn out the way Speaker Pelosi wanted it to happen, but she cannot change the laws of this Congress. She cannot unilaterally decide we're in an impeachment inquiry. What she said today made no difference of what's been going on. It's no different than what Nadler's been trying to do. It's time to put the public before politics. Thank you.
Mr. McCarthy, are you afraid that you're on the wrong side of this?
Short statement from Kevin McCarthy, the minority leader. In the House of Representatives, blasting the Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi, for formally announcing the opening of a impeachment inquiry into the President of the United States. I want to go to the President's reaction right now. He is right now on the attack as the threat of impeachment becomes more real. Our Chief White House Correspondent Jim Acosta is covering the President for us. He's up at the United Nations, where the President has been meeting with the world leaders. The speech was vastly overshadowed, his speech at the UN today, Jim, by what's going on here in Washington.
That's right, Wolf. And the president just lashed out at the House Speaker just a short while ago in her announcement of an impeachment inquiry, saying that this call for an impeachment inquiry is what he described as a breaking news, total witch hunt garbage. Now, earlier in the afternoon, the president did say he's going to release the transcript of the phone call that he had with the Ukrainian president to try to put all of this to rest. Mr. Trump has been trying to argue throughout the day that he's done nothing wrong because he says there was no quid pro quo in that conversation with the Ukrainian president, but that is not enough for former Vice President Joe Biden, who accused Mr. Trump earlier today of shredding the Constitution.
Admitting he held up military aid for Ukraine just before he pressed that country's leader to investigate former Vice President Joe Biden, President Trump offered up a new excuse for his actions. He sat on the money, the president said, to force Europe to pay their fair share.
As far as withholding funds, those funds were paid. They were fully paid. But my complaint has always been, and I'd withhold again, and I'll continue to withhold until such time as Europe and other nations contribute to Ukraine, because they're not doing it.
But the president sounded at times like he's still trying to get his story straight, insisting he didn't pressure the Ukrainians before telling reporters he did.
There was no pressure put on them whatsoever, but there was pressure put on with respect to Joe Biden. What Joe Biden did for his son, that's something they should be looking at. They have no idea how they stopped me. The only way they can try is through impeachment.
Mr. Trump has been shifting his rationale for holding up the Ukraine money, at first claiming he didn't want the funds to fuel corruption.
We're giving a lot of money away to Ukraine and other places. You want to see a country that's going to be not corrupt.
Hoping to tamp down on the controversy, the president tweeted he is authorizing the release of the complete, fully declassified and unredacted transcript of my phone conversation with President Zelensky of Ukraine. The president ordered administration officials to hold up hundreds of millions of dollars in military aid to Ukraine back in July, just 1 week before he asked Ukraine's president to investigate Biden's son Hunter's business dealings, despite zero evidence of wrongdoing. Little more than a month later, an administration official blew the whistle on Mr. Trump's conversation. 2 days after that, the Ukraine money was released. Sitting with the British Prime Minister, the president claimed he wasn't using those military funds as leverage to get what he wanted.
There was never any quid pro quo. The letter was beautiful. It was a perfect letter. It was unlike Biden, who, by the way, what he said was a horror. And ask how his son made millions of dollars from Ukraine.
The new looming Ukraine investigation hung over the president, who sounded downright low energy in his speech to the United Nations.
Wise leaders always put the good of their own people and their own country first. The future does not belong to globalists. The future belongs to patriots.
In response to the uproar, Biden fired back.
I can take the political attacks. They'll come and they'll go, and in time, they'll soon be forgotten. But if we allow a president to get away with shredding the United States Constitution, that will last forever.
The president had one other distraction at the UN in the form of 16-year-old Greta Thunberg, the young Swedish environmentalist pleading with world leaders to confront climate change. Her emotional pleas for action prompted this tweet from Mr. Trump, who appeared to mock the activist. She seems like a very happy young girl looking forward to a bright and wonderful future. So nice to see. Thunberg trolled right back, adding that comment to her Twitter bio. Restrained response that might be described as being best.
Now, the president's response by saying he's going to release the transcript of his call with President Zelensky of Ukraine is not good enough for Democrats who want to see that whistleblower complaint at the center of this investigation. And so far, the White House is not promising to provide that. As for the president, he is expected to sit down with the Ukrainian president tomorrow before holding a news conference. Mr. Trump appears to be all but daring the Democrats to impeach him. His campaign has put out a statement saying that this has energized his base, and Wolf, the campaign is fundraising off of this impeachment inquiry tonight.